Christmas. We love this time of year.
Yeah, wrapping presents, decorating the tree, and generally making merry.
And nothing beats a bit of Christmas home cooking shared with family and friends.
Delicious festive food for all occasions, packed with flavour and full of love. Ding dong merrily on high.
And we'll be joined by some familiar faces to get us all into the festive spirit.
Oh, my goodness.
That is preposterously wonderful.
Yes. Merry Christmas.
We'll also find out how to make someone's day with delicious homemade foodie gifts.
So, hang up your stockings, tweak your tinsel,
turn on your fairy lights and relax.
We're home for Christmas!
It's Christmas Day. The presents are wrapped, the house is decorated, and the tree is lit.
Now, for a cook, it's the perfect time to show off. Everybody's looking forward to your Christmas dinner, so what do? Pull out all the stops.
Christmas makes memories, and with our suggestions for a spectacular lunch, the family will be talking about it for generations.
We're making delicious stuffed turkey legs and breast.
And a spectacular Christmas croque en bouche.
We're joined by Reverend Kate Botley, television's favourite vicar.
I only went for a snog and I ended up with a dog collar.
But first, a dish that looks great and tastes even better.
Yep, we're going to be cooking a cherry and bourbon glazed gammon ham with a lovely winter butternut squash salad. Now, like most things at Christmas, we always say it's good to get ahead, and we have got ahead with this. The first thing you must do is get rid of the salt. So you put that into a pot, bring it to the boil, and then chuck the water away, and then put that back into the pot again, filled with water, and this is what you boil it in.
So these are your aromatics. Some celery, carrot, onion, cloves, pepper, allspice. Not forgetting the bay leaves and some thyme.
Now, we simmer that gammon away for 2 to 2.5 hours in its aromatics. I'm going to make the cherry and bourbon glaze. It just lifts that gammon onto new heights.
Now, you see there is a layer of skin here. Well, what we're going to do is we're going to just take that off nice and gently. And sometimes it'll just pull off, and sometimes you might need to give it a little bit of a helping hand with a knife, because we don't want that. We just want the fat layer underneath.
Now, to start the glaze, we start with some cherry conserve, basically cherry jam. Black cherry jam or regular cherry jam will do fine. Put that in a bowl, then we add some brown sugar, some cinnamon, some bourbon. And I think bourbon really does work with this. You could use Scotch whiskey, but I think it might be a bit peaty.
Yeah, bourbon has that sweetness to it, doesn't it?
Now I've got like a thumb end of ginger. I'm going to peel this and I'm going to chop it very, very finely and put it into my mixture.
Now, while Dave's doing his ginger, I'm going to start to put the little crosshatches that make it so lovely.
Now, I take this ginger, put it into the bowl with my bourbon, my cinnamon, my sugar and my cherry jam, and I give that a good mix. And then I put it into a saucepan and I'm going to boil it till it is a jammy glaze. Oh, lovely. God, it smells boozy. Whoo! Do you know, Simon, a Christmas fact?
Oh, go on.
In Britain, over the Christmas period, we drink enough beer to fill 57 swimming pools. That's a fact.
Do we?
We do.
Flipping heck. Whoa. Here. You nearly lost your touch there, dude. Hold on, the left bit's gone a bit limp.
No, hold on. Watch this. Aladdin. Woof, there's the genie. Let's put the fire out. And we don't do anything daft like put water in it. It's good, isn't it? Without oxygen, fire can't function.
No.
There we go. Look at that.
I'm going to start a stud with cloves, Dave.
I always think that a gammon like this looks like a hobnail boot.
That's lovely.
Oh, it is lovely. See, look at that, Si. We've burned the alcohol off. It's just gone like a wonderful, rich glaze.
Oh, you know it's Christmas when you're doing this.
Yeah. It's like a pork quilt, isn't it?
Yeah. Right there.
Right, let's get the painters in.
Now that's starting to look like a gammon.
Oh, aye. There you go, mate.
Thank you. So that goes into a preheated oven at 200 degrees C for 20 to 25 minutes. If you fancy putting another glaze on halfway through, please do. Now, what we're going to do is strip the outside of that butternut squash off, cut it and dice it.
Do you want me to chop the garlic for you, mate?
Yeah, that'd be great, thanks.
Kingy, when you were little, around Christmas dinner, what was your childhood treat?
Oh, it was the first thing in the morning, dipping bread into the turkey juices. It was brilliant. You used to lift the foil up, make sure my mum wasn't about, and she'd always have hot bread, so I always used to nick a bit and then just lift the turkey foil up, open the oven, home. Hot, oh, it was so lovely.
Hot turkey fat?
Hot turkey fat, and all the cooking juices soaked into mum's homemade bread, little bit of salt on, it was epic.
And what do you call that?
Turkey dippers.
Turkey dippers. Hey, gosh.
What about you, Dave? What was yours?
I seem to remember on Christmas Eve, it was always the time for making the stock and the giblet gravy. And my dad would always make some soup with kind of pulses and barley. And funny enough, it was all my dad that had a leading hand in Christmas dinner, not my mum. And
right.
It was the Christmas Eve turkey soup because the bird was such a big event, a big expense.
Yes.
And I remember that soup. And eating late at night as well, that was always so exciting. We always had a proper roaring fire on. And the anticipation was ridiculous.
I know, that's it.
You know, for what's going to happen the next day. Now, I'm going to sprinkle the chopped garlic over the squash.
Right, that's us. I'll get some oil.
Spread it out. Give each bit of squash its share of the garlic world.
A little bit of oil.
And some thyme.
Now, this is dried thyme, it's not fresh.
Yep. One of the rules with cooking, you cook dried herbs and spices into a dish from the beginning and you finish off with fresh.
Now, if you could pass a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper, I'll stick that on and get it in the oven.
Well, I'll make a dressing for this wonderful salad. Can I have your olive oil?
You certainly can.
Like most dressings, this one starts with olive oil. Some lovely, sharp red wine vinegar. I've got some Dijon mustard, whole grain mustard, you know, the lumpy one. Now, lastly, some honey. So it really is sweet and savoury, and it's lovely with the squash.
200 degrees, 25 minutes.
Which, ironically, is about the same time as your gammon.
There we go.
Beautiful. Oh. They've gone really kind of sticky and roasted and lovely.
Haven't they just?
Oh,
oh, yes. Look at this, boy.
Oh.
Oh, that is fantastic,
that is,
man.
Beautiful, isn't it? I've got it. Now, look at that. I don't think a Christmas Day main event can look much better than that.
It's beautiful.
It is. I'll just make a bed of spinach leaves for the salad. I think spinach is great for winter salads.
Look at the colours, man.
Yeah.
It's great.
Just drizzle some of that honey and mustard dressing.
Oh, lovely.
And now just scatter some of the lovely toasted pumpkin seeds.
And now for our beautiful, beautiful gammon. That is perfect. Absolutely perfect. Mm. Oh, that bourbon glaze is superb.
Oh.
That is superb.
Ding dong, merrily on high.
Mm-hmm.
That is absolutely belting. This cherry and bourbon glazed gammon with winter squash and crunch seed salad will be a magnificent centrepiece for any Christmas table.
Thank you.